Hello, and welcome to the Harmonagon Project. In our first video on the circle of fifths, we covered construction, using perfect fifth intervals and their inversions as perfect fourths. Now we'll explore this structure on a deeper level. The circle of fifths is a tone row, or a sequence that uses all 12 notes without repeating, except for the added octave at the end. Other than a repetition of 12 semitones, only a combination of 12 perfect fifths and their inversions as perfect fourths will produce a chromatic scale. The circle of fifths also creates harmonic symmetry between the major and minor intervals or tonalities, which are all relative to the tonic C. The first half of the ascending circle of fifths is plainly major. Beginning in ascending order from the tonic C, we have the perfect fifth G natural, the major second D natural, the major sixth A natural, the major third E natural, the major seventh B natural, and the augmented fourth F sharp. While the second half of the ascending circle of fifths is clearly minor, continuing from the tritone G-flat, we have the minor 2nd D-flat, the minor 6th A-flat, the minor 3rd E-flat, the minor 7th B-flat, the perfect 4th F, and the octave tonic C. In this case, where C is the tonic, the F-sharp or G-flat tritone evenly bisects the circle and is equidistant from the tonic and its octave. For this reason, the tritone is harmonically ambiguous and may be considered major or minor, depending on the context of its use. Now let's examine the descending circle of fifths. The first half of the descending circle of fifths is plainly minor. Beginning in descending order from the tonic C, we have the perfect fourth F, inverted here a perfect fifth down, then the minor seventh B flat, the minor 3rd E-flat, the minor 6th A-flat, the minor 2nd D-flat, and the diminished 5th G-flat. While the second half of the descending circle of fifths is clearly major, continuing from the tritone F-sharp, we have the major 7th B-natural, the major 3rd E-natural, the major 6th A-natural, the major 2nd D-natural, the perfect fifth G natural, and finally the tonic C. As you can see, both the ascending and descending circle of fifths contain the same 12 notes. Only the sequence, order, and direction are changed. You may have noticed that the first half of the ascending circle of fifths is made from the same notes as the Lydian major scale. Here, in ascending order, we have the tonic C, the major 2nd D, the major 3rd E, the augmented 4th F sharp, the perfect 5th G, the major 6th A, and the major 7th B. Notice that there are no minor intervals. Thus, the Lydian is the most major of all scales. The second half of the ascending circle of fifths is made from the same notes as the Locrian minor scale. Here we have the tonic C, the minor 2nd D flat, the minor 3rd E flat, the perfect 4th F, the diminished 5th G flat, the minor 6th A flat, and the minor 7th B flat. Notice that there are no major intervals. Thus, the Locrian is the most minor of all scales. I recommend that you practice playing both the ascending and descending circle of fifths with your instrument and the harmonagon. You should also practice playing the Lydian major and Locrian minor scales to see and hear how each fit perfectly within the structure of the circle of fifths. Until next time, have a nice day.